Good afternoon, Radha Krishna. Thank you for joining me today. How are you?
Good, good. Good morning to you in Italy.
Thank you.
Thank you for having this interview.
Oh, thank you for joining me, really. Radha Krishna, let me introduce you. You are Dr. Radha Krishna Pillai. You are an associate professor at the Indian Institute of Technology of Madras, Chennai, India, and a very active RILA member. And this is the reason why you are here today with me. Good. Radha Krishna, you graduated in India, but then you moved to the USA to complete your studies, your PhD study, and you were awarded your PhD in the USA. But then you moved back to India to continue your academic career. And now, you, as I said, you are the Indian Institute of Technology Madras. And my database, the RILA database, tells me that you joined RILA in 2013. Can you tell us something about that period? Where were you in your career? How did everything happen?
Yeah, I heard about RILA during my PhD time in Texas A&M University, while looking for journals and things like that. So I heard about RILA before, but I was, not planning to join at that time, mainly because of many reasons, and then after joining IIT Madras, the group here, I found very active in RILA, especially Professor Ravindra Gettu and Professor Manu Santanam. And that's where I thought of, okay, I need to join the team and joined RILA in 2013.
And yeah, Professor Ravindra Ravindra Gettu is currently the RILA president, for those who do not know about this. Okay, so it was basically, it was more dictated by the environment in which you ended up working. And
yes.
Good. And then in 2018, after 5 years, you became the RILA regional convener for South Asia. Can you tell us how that happened and what is your role in RILA?
Since I joined, I used to start attending RILA programs, lectures, etc., and also organizing many RILA events in India. And also many events, including PhD courses, and the 71st RILA Week, which was held in Chennai in 2017. I was very much part of the organizing team. I think probably by seeing how I'm doing, what I'm doing, I think Professor Gettu or Professor Manu, I don't know who recommended me, but one of them for sure has nominated me for the regional convener. And I think I took the convener position from Professor Manu. He was the regional convener before me. suitable person to continue.
And what is your role? What do you do as a regional convener in South Africa?
I think, my main role, I believe, is to make sure that the people in this region come together, and also to increase the membership, which I thought is an important task, because it's still not known to many people who are still in the research arena. So we are still working on making more good membership, not just memberships, people who are involved or who are interested in contributing to RILA activities. So we try to identify such people and then, get them into the team or making them take memberships.
Thank you. And on this,
I think
matter,
so far we have been very successful,
yes,
in that also.
It's true. I was going to say that we had skyrocketing numbers of members from South Asia since you joined as a regional convener. So definitely you're doing a great job. But I was wondering, what's your vision of RILA in India or in South Asia in general? Your expertise or your area of research are in the reinforcement in steel reinforcement corrosion in concrete. What would you see as a topic that RALEM maybe should push forward for the interest of researchers in that area where you work, or if any? Would you have
I would say the RILEM, as it has been doing, it should push forward all areas associated with construction materials, not one specific area, but generally the to ensure that good quality construction is going to happen in future. So that's the underlying goal of any RILEM activity, I think. So all construction materials, not necessarily cement or concrete, but also we should increase our activities in other areas, like bituminous materials or other construction materials. Because as you know, primarily, a lot of people are working on cement and concrete, but other areas also we need to probably increase our involvement in.
Even in South Asia,
so we've seen that this topic. Say all construction materials.
Okay, I see. And I'm curious to know.
We can make it maybe in such, if that happens, then we can say we'll also get more people because, the quality of general construction would probably improve if we really not only focus on cement and concrete, but also other allied materials. Which we use in construction. So we can say we are truly a materials people, construction materials, not just cement and concrete.
Fantastic. And I would like to know about the benefits of RILEM in your career. What do you think you have gained after so many years being a RILEM member?
I would say I met a lot of people who are working in my area, and I have personal contacts with them. So that's, I think, the most important benefit. And we know who is doing what, and also kind of learn the trend in research, which can also, people can say, I can read journal papers and get the trend. But still, there's a lot of difference between meeting the person directly in RILEM programs and, getting, the communication, it's much better. You start, feeling like what is happening in your area of research in other parts of the world also.
Right. So being updated and having a great network.
Yeah, being updated. Yeah. In one word, if you want to say, being updated, not only from the journals, but from the people directly who are actually doing the leading cutting edge research.
Yeah. And based on your experience, would you recommend other people to join RILEM, and especially definitely young people?
Definitely, yes. Because, in my personal experience, I didn't realize the benefits when I was young. Before joining, but now I can see a very, as I told earlier, a lot of benefits, which you cannot really write in bullet points, but you kind of feel the benefits of joining. Which is the problem. Most of the time when we ask for people to join, they say immediately, what is the benefit? But these are all tangible benefits, so which we'll realize after a few years of working with RILEM. But, it's not similar to joining other associations, but in RILEM, you have, excellent students coming. We can see excellent students coming for the programs. Excellent researchers and academicians. So it's a little different from the other organizations where you will see a wide spectrum of people. Here, it's all people who are really worried about science and technology all the discussions are revolved around that. So that's, I think, a beauty of RILEM and the difference between RILEM and probably other associations. I'm not saying that the other associations don't. But here there is a big focus on science and technology, I think. So definitely it's a yes for young members, to join. Lot of benefits. And also now for the young members, which I think we define as people with less than 35 years
age.
So all the young members, they get highly subsidized the fee. I mean, fee structure is very subsidized for young members. I think now it is affordable for at least South Asian countries. I can definitely say it is affordable. I don't know about the other part of the world, but this region, I think the current fee structure is very much affordable, which is for India, it's coming to be about 10 euros, which is like close to 800, 900 Indian rupees.
I want to specify why from 25 to 10, because certain countries around the world benefit from a discount between 40 and 60%. So in India in particular, there is a discount of 60% in the membership fees. So from 25 to 10.
Many South Asian countries do get that benefit.
Many other, yes. And Radhakrishna, what about the RALEM annual week? We have an event this year that is going to be hybrid, means people that can attend in person will attend in person. People that for any other reason cannot during this pandemic will attend remotely. Are you joining? And what do you think of these remote meetings?
Just because of the pandemic, I'm not able to join.
Mm-hmm. In person?
But okay. Online, definitely, yes.
Okay. Yeah.
Be participating online.
Okay.
And my students are also, you know, we have a large number of students from here who has submitted their abstracts and going to make presentations, mostly online again, but our participation is there.
Fantastic. And we are not going to reveal anything, but can we jump to something that is strictly related to the PhD students in Madras? And let's talk about the PhD grant. Would you like to tell us something about this?
Two of our students got the grant this time. And I think that's very, very good for them. It's, you know, free trip. And both of them are actually going to Mexico. It's a very good for, you know, for other students also to start seeing, okay, so if I work hard, I might get the free trip, you know, a free travel grant. That's good. Very good initiative from RILEM side, I think.
To be able to join in person.
Financial stress is too much at that time. So when you get this money, it's very good. It's a big opportunity for them to see the people whom they have seen only in journal papers, their names, and then really meeting them. I think it makes a difference at that age.
I agree. Radhakrishna, I have just one last question. Would you have any thought or experience to share with us about your years in RILEM? Your point of view of RALEM, how it's going in the future, or something funny or interesting that happened to you in the past years?
Nothing very particular to say. I'm very happy with, you know, that's what I would like to say. I'm very happy to be part of RILEM. I don't really see much negative. One main thing is the TCs, you know, it's very, very good. You know, you start seeing the different schools of thought in the TC rooms, you know, on the same topic, different people have, you know, different thoughts. Both are correct, probably, or different, I would say. But, you know, you start also seeing or thinking that, you know, there are other ways by which you people can think, right? And then how to make consensus. That's very, very important, you know, on technical points. So that's, I think it's the intricate discussions on small things, for the research, it's very useful and it really enriching, I think.
Oh, this is great. Okay.
The small things you worry about too much, you know, when you talk about research, which is not known to the other people who are not actually working in that area. So that's good to know that the difficulties which we face are also faced by others while doing experiments and trying to solve problems. That's a good thing.
I agree.
Details. Yeah.
I agree. And also personally, what I like about RILEM and the technical committees is the interdisciplinary aspect. The fact yes. that you meet engineers, you meet chemists, you meet architects, you meet...
it's not only civil engineers.
Physicists, yes, yes. This is very, very important. So you have really different points of view, and this can only be enriching in terms of research outcomes. Yeah.
It opens up your mind, you know.
Yes, so I agree.
You start thinking, oh, maybe I'm wrong. I was wrong. Maybe this is the better way of doing.
Yeah, never thought of this. It's true. Radhakrishna, it was super kind of you to join me today. I think we are done. And I hope to see you. I hope we can meet each other soon in a next event, hopefully in person, if this sure. pandemic allows us. Yes.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for having me here. Thank you.